Alright, what's going on, guys? So today, we're going to be taking a look at how much better I think the New York Rangers are with adding a guy like Vladimir Tarasenko, who obviously has, you know, top-line talent. He is a top-line winger. He's one of the better, you know, goal scorers over the past, like, decade or so in the entire NHL. He's a very good goal scorer, a very good all-around offensive player. Obviously, he's not, like, a great, like, two-way wing by any means, but definitely that offense is amazing with Vladimir Tarasenko. And adding a guy like Terry, he is a very good player. And obviously, he has a connection with Artemi Panarin. Obviously, they played together at the 2010-2011 World Juniors. And, Panarin kind of talked about how, like, Vladimir Tarasenko helped him, you know, when joining that kind of World Junior Russian team, obviously, way back in 2010. He said, he took care of me. I've always thanked him for that. Obviously, Panarin talking about Vladimir Tarasenko. So, very cool that, like, you know, 12 years, like 13, whatever it was, years later, you know, they're reunited and whatever on the same team and obviously doing very, very well together. And I'm sure if, you know, if the Russians get allowed to play in the World Championships for hockey or whatever, the Olympics or whatever it is coming up again, I'm sure they could be on the line together. It's definitely a possibility, just considering, you know, they are two star wingers and obviously they clearly have a bit of chem and clearly like each other. And they played amazing last night. I mean, obviously, Vladimir Tarasenko scored a goal with the Rangers, his first goal in his first game with the Rangers, got his first point within 2 minutes and 49 seconds of the start of last night's game against the Seattle Kraken. Absolutely amazing. I mean, this is the fourth fastest debut goal in Rangers history. So, like, obviously the fastest was Norm Lowe in a minute. A minute into his debut, he scored in 1950. And then a guy did it, Lane Lambert. He scored 2 minutes and 28 seconds into his time in 1986. And then Mike Allison, he scored his in 2 minutes and 44 seconds into his debut in the 1980s. And then, obviously, there hasn't been one since now with that quick. So, obviously, that is very cool to see. The fourth fastest debut goal in Rangers history. Very, very quick there. Very, very cool to see. It was just a good pass. I mean, like, him and Panarin came up, obviously. What a surprise. Panarin was the guy who did it, right? his new buddy. Panarin makes a nice pass over, and, he just kind of takes that forehand kind of one-tee shot and just, you know, shoots really, really quick. Nice snapshot, five-hole, buries it, and obviously Tarasenko's a goal scorer. He's going to score those goals most of the time. Obviously, he had quite a few chances last night. Tarasenko did, and he could have had a hat trick last night if he just fully buried on all those chances, because he had quite a few really, really good chances. I remember another chance where he had, that was pretty much identical to his goal, where, like, you know, he was receiving a pass from Panarin again, and he just, you know, he had to stick on the ice. He was right in front of the net, ready for it, and obviously he shot it right away, right when he got it, and almost buried it five-hole again, but it was a good stop by Martin Jones. I just think, you know, Tarasenko, he had an amazing game, and I think he really showed last night that, like, adding another guy like that to Panarin and Zibanejad to that top line, and then you can have, you know, your whole line. So look at this tweet here. So from Vince Macagliano, oh, this is the Rangers, like, warm-up rushers last night. What I'm talking about is having Panarin, Zib, and Tarasenko on that top line. Obviously, you know, like, that is an elite offensive line, and then you have your second and third line of, like, you know, whether you want to have, like, the kid line as a second line or Kreider and Trocheck, that kind of line as that second line, you can debate. But I think Laf, Hedl, and Kako are just so amazing together. They've been so great this season together that I think just having them as that third line or second line, whatever it is, I think they're more the second line. But, you know, it just, we've added so much good forward depth, because now you have another line of Kreider, Trocheck, and Kravtsov, who are great offensive players themselves. And hopefully, you know, Kravtsov can start taking a step forward and stuff like that. But, I mean, we've clearly seen that out of the kid line this year, and they're really taking a step forward. To have three good scoring lines, I think, it's just amazing to have. Kravtsov, he missed a great chance last night to bury one. He had, like, a wide open net, and then Martin Jones just slides over and just robs him pretty early on. Actually, I think that was before the, I believe that was before the Tarasenko goal, like, right before it. And then, like two chances later, the Rangers had, then obviously Tarasenko scored his goal. But, I mean, Kravtsov, he almost had one really, really early on in the game, and the Rangers just took over this entire game. And I think this kind of forward core just shows you how good, like, when you have so much good depth and a lot of good high-end talent, it is really good for a team. Like, we have, like, some elite wingers. That top line is so elite. And then you have a great, you know, two other really, really good lines of Kreider, Trocheck, Kravtsov, and Laf, Hedl, Kako. And then you also have a decent fourth line of, you know, Jimmy VC, Gaudreau, and Gauthier. And, I mean, obviously, the deadline, I think I would love to see us add a very good defensive forward, you know, throwing that fourth line with Gaudreau. Maybe you slide Gaudreau to the wing and have a really good defensive center on that fourth line, and then maybe have VC on the other wing or whatever it is. I mean, or Gauthier or whoever it is. But I think if we can add another really good defensive forward at the deadline, I think our forward core is kind of almost set. right? I think Gaudreau, a really good defensive forward, and then maybe, you know, VC or Gauthier, whoever it is, on that fourth line, I think it's pretty solid. And then your D-core obviously is set for the playoffs now, pretty much, with Lindgren, Fox, Miller, Trouba, Mikula, and Schneider. Maybe we add another depth D-man, maybe. But I think Mikula is pretty solid. And maybe you don't trust Ben Harper a whole lot. Maybe you'd rather add in another guy. But it's definitely a possibility going into playoffs that we could add one more guy. But I think this team is so much better with adding Tarasenko. Tarasenko is such a good offensive dynamic player. He's a multi-time, like, 40-goal guy. He's going to score, like, 30 goals pretty much every single season. Obviously, it's kind of a rental move, but I just think it's worth it, you know, considering you add in such a good offensive player. I mean, we've just got so many great offensive talent guys. I mean, Zibanejad, he's got 26 goals and 28 assists, 54 points in 52 games. Panarin, he's got 54 points in 52 games. Fox is 50 points in 52 games. Trocheck even has 37 points in 52 games, not bad. Kreider's got 35 points in 49 games. And then Hedl is absolutely making a breakout. I'm going to have a video probably tomorrow on Hedl, just kind of talking about how he's broken out and really just taken another step this year with 33 points in 44 games, 19 goals. He has been so good this year. A plus 17 from Hedl as well. I mean, his two-way game, his overall game has just gotten so much better, and he's still not even getting a crap ton of ice time. He's still only getting 14 minutes and 28 seconds per game on average. And when you compare that to a guy like Trocheck, who's getting like 19 minutes, 59 seconds, pretty much 20 minutes, he's almost getting like 4.5 more minutes than Hedl. So it's crazy that how good Hedl's doing, and he's not even getting a whole lot of crap ton of ice time. He's even getting less ice time than actually Lafreniere and Kako are. So it's actually pretty crazy to see how well he's doing. But obviously those guys have taken a step forward too. I mean, you know, Lafreniere, he's on pace for like a 40-ish point season. So that's good to see as well. And same with Kako. So it's nice to see that the kid line is taking a big step forward. And hopefully we can see them all get 40-plus points and really take a big step next year even further. But I mean, this game, I mean, it was a great game all around, okay? Like, Tarasenko, obviously, he scored. The kid line scored. Everyone looked great. Tarasenko had so many good chances. I'm so excited to see what this Rangers team can do with adding a guy like Tarasenko in. And I definitely think Tarasenko is a perfect add for this New York Rangers team, who are looking to obviously go on a much longer run, hopefully, maybe even get to the Stanley Cup final this season compared to last season where we lost against in game six. You know, obviously losing four straight to the Tampa Bay Lightning. Hopefully, we can make it to the Cup final this year and maybe even win it. I think we have a great team. I think we have definitely a good chance. We have the goalie. We have the D-core to do it. We have the forwards to do it. I think we just, you know, add a couple more depth guys, add in some more strong talent, and hopefully, you know, Igor can get back to his prime form like last season, and we can go on a good Cup run. Anyways, guys, let me know guys' thoughts on this, you know, the Rangers adding Tarasenko, and how much better this team is. Let me know guys' thoughts on that in the comment section down below. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe. Peace.